Time to Speak for Yourself, the most fearless show in sports. Jason Whitlock, Marcellus Wiley, joined again by Rick Bucher and LeVar Arrington. Time now for the most fearless discussion of the day. All right, according to ESPN's Adam Schefter, NFL Commissioner Roger Goodell has organized a special workout for former NFL quarterback turned silent Twitter activist Colin Kaepernick. Schefter said today that Goodell arranged the workout this Saturday in Atlanta because Goodell feels bad about how things have turned out for Kaepernick, who has remained unemployed the past three seasons after being radicalized by his girlfriend Nessa and staging a national anthem protest. Kaepernick and his team of exploiters slash lawyers sued the NFL for collusion and then settled out of court for a small sum of money. He has maintained relevancy via social media by switching between cornrows and an afro, objecting to the Betsy Ross flag, wearing a wide assortment of dashikis, and retweeting famous quotes. My point is, I understand why Roger Goodell feels sorry for Colin Kaepernick. Cap has been used and abused by forces Cap doesn't fully understand. People took advantage of his justifiable identity crisis and defined his identity as a black man by his willingness to torch his football career in a pointless publicity stunt. Oh, I get it. Cap is a victim, but not of the NFL. He eats dinner and socializes with his true enemies every day. But I would caution the commissioner with the words I tell all young people: pity don't pay no bills. What I mean by that is pity is a fool's currency. It has virtually no tangible value. It serves the giver's conscience far more than it does the receiver's future empowerment or opportunity. I think Goodell is aware of this. I believe that's why the workout is scheduled for this Saturday rather than next Tuesday or the following Saturday. Kaepernick and his supporters are upset Goodell did not arrange the workout at a time when it would be more convenient for top-level scouts and executives to attend. Goodell is already bending over here. What's he arranged? He's already arranged an unprecedented workout for Kaepernick. Is he going to schedule a workout for Dez Bryant? Dez tore his Achilles. He's out of work and looking for his next NFL opportunity. Is Dez unworthy of empathy? No. Goodell and football people want to see how bad Cap wants back in the NFL. That's important. The NFL doesn't need Colin Kaepernick. It doesn't need Antonio Brown. It doesn't need any of these guys who believe they're bigger than the game. Can Cap get through this workout without painting himself as a victim? He's off to a bad start. His tweet last night indicates a level of delusion that's scary. He said he's looking forward to seeing head coaches and general managers at the workout. Cap thinks he's Tua Tagovailoa or Chase Young, the hottest prospects on the market. Cap should be happy if a half dozen teams send an area scout and a stopwatch. Mm. All right, guys. Marcellus.
Yeah.
Is this workout a good idea?
Not for Colin Kaepernick. For the NFL, yes. And I preface this by saying my grandma used to always tell me, baby, you can't make sense out of nonsense, but I'm going to try. Like you said, unprecedented. Never seen this before. An active player getting the opportunity. And this opportunity seems forced. This opportunity seems like it's coming from the NFL. And I know there are reports out there that this is not a part of the NDA, part of the settlement, but I would disagree with that. I think this is what an NDA looks like. Okay, we have our understandings that we're going to give you another opportunity to at least audition for everyone else, even if it's not a real chance. So Colin Kaepernick is within a week of a workout is told, be here. This is where your workout is. Colin Kaepernick is not mutually agreed upon these terms, but why isn't Colin Kaepernick tapping out of those terms or tapping out of this workout? Because he can't. So now he's going to show up within 5 days of a workout, put on his best performance without even knowing who will be in attendance. Wanted to change the date. Nope, not going on another Saturday. Wanted to change the date. Nope, we're not going on a Tuesday when you can ensure a greater participation and attendance. To me, these are the fine print examples of what an NDA looks like, and this is part of that settlement.
Non-disclosure agreement. Go ahead.
Yes.
I don't see how this serves anybody's purpose. For me, the Colin Kaepernick controversy had died down and was in the rearview mirror. Mm. This only brings it all back. And to suggest that it proves that the NFL has always had its door open to Colin Kaepernick, that certainly doesn't do it for me either. It's been 3 years, and we're talking about this workout not being for now, but being for next season. So we're really talking 4 years now. So all you do is bring this back. Look, I was down with the cause and where this started, what Kaepernick's protest and what he was trying to bring attention to. I was down with that. The carrying out of that message is where he lost me because there was no messaging. I just did a podcast with Derrick Rose, and we talked about the fact that he allowed other people to tell his narrative. He was the first one to wear the I Can't Breathe t-shirt. Derrick Rose was the first one. A week later, LeBron goes to New York, plays Brooklyn. He wears the t-shirt. Now, this is post Derrick Rose knee injuries. This is LeBron going back to Cleveland and being the hometown hero. Derrick, when he wore the t-shirt, didn't talk to the media. Did it a couple days later. Didn't at the time. So now other people took the narrative. That's what Colin Kaepernick has allowed to have happen. And what I see is that continuing now, because he's no more in charge of what's going on than he was at the very beginning
of this. He's not capable of being in charge.
It's bad for Cap. Really bad. Super bad. All-time bad. Bad, bad, bad. Michael Jackson bad. And the reality for me is that for something that you gave your career away for, you gave it to the people. Let's for a better way of stating it, you gave your career away for the people. You wanted people to understand what social injustice represents. You're using your platform, and now you don't have it. The fact that you are trying so hard and so desperately to get back to the place of where you condemned and protested and messaged what you wanted to become, what you became, I think it exposes a light on the fact that this is not about social injustice for Colin Kaepernick. It's about Colin Kaepernick. So it's a bad idea. If you ride out into the sunset being who you are, I did this, I took the knee, I'm not in the league because of it, everybody knows it, keep getting your work. I hate this whole narrative of he's out of work. It's a shame he's out of work. No, he doesn't work for the NFL. The same employer that you chose to do your protesting. I find it to be very damning to him, and I don't like it in the sense that it exposes him for being selfish versus being someone who's for the community.
I like Rick's point of I'm not sure if this is good for the NFL. I think a lot of people think, you know, this is going to work out good and makes the NFL look good. I think it just drags this whole conversation back to the forefront. And to me, they're having it on Saturday. All this woke media is going to cover it like it's the, you know, the Olympic Games. There'll be more media than coaches and interested football people. And they're doing it at the same time. I'm like, man, my whole weekend is built around Lamar Jackson versus Deshaun Watson. Guys, I can't wait to see play football. Not some guy that hasn't played for several years. I just don't get this. The NFL just had one of its best weekends ever in terms of excitement, games, and blah, blah, blah. And now here we go again with Colin Kaepernick. Bad play by the NFL.
Great play by the NFL. Let's trust in this, $18 billion economy that they created, that there is a method to their madness in all respects. And I'm going to tell you what it is. Colin Kaepernick has stayed relevant in martyrdom. And in martyrdom, it's activated in death or silence.
So bring him back to life.
So let's bring him back to life and let
destroy
him kill himself.
Kill himself.
Show that video. We Come taping on, this. Show this video. We taping this. Every team gonna get to see it.
Come on.
Taping the interview as well.
Come on.
We want to hear it because you know what happened when your lawyer comes out a couple months ago and says, you know what, I want to clear the air of all the misconceptions, which I know he was talking to me because everybody else been saying stuff for years. Nobody else got a lawyer or an agent to talk, and then all of a sudden, boom! Right after I say it, okay. So let's talk. Let's volley. You want to clear the air, so the NFL says, oh. You think that our discussions aren't private. You want to clear misconceptions. So what now the NFL will do is say, Colin Kaepernick, here's your chance. Are you ready for that opportunity? Are you thriving in this moment? And it's on Cap. I'm not saying that he's going to fail. I'm saying that the NFL is going to get rid of what has been carrying his platform for this many years, which is martyrdom. Mm-hmm. Now we're going to get to substance. We're going to get to production. We're going to get from imagination to reality and let the world
see. The genius of it, to me, the genius of it is that it's the NFL. It's Roger Goodell. Roger put himself out there. I want to see this happen. I don't like the way it ended, da-da-da, blah, blah, blah. It's the NFL. So if the NFL is facilitating this, that doesn't mean they don't. The NFL doesn't facilitate to each and every one of those franchises and to those owners and to them GMs and say, you have to hire him because the NFL sanctioned this workout. It's genius.
To the point it's of genius. Don't think that Roger Goodell woke up yesterday with a different moral compass.
No.
Like, just look, I love me some Roger Goodell. I love the opportunity for Colin Kaepernick, and I wish everybody who wants to achieve their dreams good luck. But do not think that the NFL just woke up and said, you know what? Man, he deserves a chance.
Right.
This is calculated, y'all.
Absolutely.
And we're going to see how it plays.
I get that, but I can't erase that it's been 3 years. Just because you're saying, oh, you want a shot now? The odds are against Colin Kaepernick being able to. We go in knowing it, that the chances of him looking good when he doesn't even know the circumstances are against him.
But that,
you have to know that. So that doesn't erase the fact that for 3 years there have been guys that have been on rosters and that have gotten an opportunity to try out. Bottom, whatever the case may be, it's been 3 years he hasn't played. This doesn't erase that. What I really don't understand is why Colin at this point is taking part in this.
Because he signed on to this. Let me just, I've signed a few NDAs.
Signed on to what? I don't know what he signed up for.
Look, in part, this is my opinion-based information. When we're signing this settlement, one of the things I want in this, on top of monetary compensation, is an opportunity. And Roger Goodell says, you know what? Within a calendar year or season, you will get your opportunity. And here's your audition.
I'm gonna tell you, the other thing is Colin Kaepernick, surrounded by his enemies that he thinks are his best friend, he can't see himself doing anything else but playing football.
Which is trust, so strange.
It's strange. It's wrong. Because trust me, if I'm denied work here for 3 weeks, I'm going to find something else to do. Because that's exactly in my moral fiber. That's what my parents demanded. That's what my whole life is built around. You're not going to deny me work. I'm going to go out and create it myself if I have to. Again, it's like, again, my father started his own business because he didn't
tell
like the way.
Name.
Jimmy Whitlock.
Jimmy
Whitlock. Because they didn't like the way. If my mother can work and has worked her entire life, a black woman that was born in the 30s, she can. This dude that was born last week, he can't get a damn job? You can't get out of here. I don't feel
the
sorry.
The unemployment part is strange.
It's embarrassing. As a man, I would be offended by
you
that.
You can't use unemployed.
You sitting around on your ass healthy for 3 years,
talk
any man, you should be embarrassed.
Tell them how you feel.
Any woman should be embarrassed.
Coming up. I agree with that.
We'll continue our conversation on Colin Kaepernick and tell you if he can still help an NFL team.